Having Mocha's Object Brush and Matte Assist directly inside Sapphire plugins opens up a huge number of opportunities to create eye-catching effects. I'm Ben Brownlee for Boris FX, and here are my top tips for getting the most out of your AI-powered mats in Sapphire. Tracking and masking are now broken up into two separate tabs inside of Essentials mode. Tracking works as it's always done before, and Mask opens up the auto mask propagation tools. If you're selecting humans with the object brush, always start with the head. If it's taking in any extraneous details, just right-click to add a red dot to remove other highlighted areas. If you want the whole body, again, start with the head somewhere near the top, and then click on a body part somewhere down near the bottom. And likewise, if we want a particular limb, click on that, then right click, and that will usually just hold out the body part that we are looking for. Always remember to finish your shape if you're using the object brush, either by clicking on the big finish button in the toolbar, or by selecting the arrow tool. This will show you the spline that Matte Assist will then propagate across the rest of the shot. Sometimes you won't be able to get a clean selection just by using the object brush, even if you add in red dots to try to limit the selection. So before you finish the shape, come into the area brush with a plus sign, and then if I hold down the Alt key, I can then clean up all of the little dots that I need to prior to finishing my shape. And if I don't hold down the Alt key, I can just add to my selection. And just remember to come back to the main object brush and finish that up. We can then propagate that mask across the rest of the frame. And if you do see any small splines that have been created by accident, you can always just go in, right click on that, go to Spline, delete spline, and that will keep the other shapes intact. You don't have to use the object brush to use Matte Assist. Any layer will work. You just have to remember a couple of things. First, make sure that you right click on the spline and go Spline Single Frame On. So this will only be visible on the keyframes. And also remember to go into Mask and turn on Generate Object Matte. We'll then use Matte Assist ML to propagate this across the rest of the frames. And also, you don't have to use Matte Assist with anything you create with your object brush. You can just do regular tracking with it. And if you're going to do this, there's a couple of things to remember. Just right click, go to spline, and turn the single frame off, so that we know that this spline is going to work across the entire range. And if you've got multiple splines, as we do here, remember to do that for all of them. Now we can see that those splines exist across the whole range. Also, turn off Generate Object Matte in the Mask tab. You'll see the silicon chip disappears from that layer, and I can now go into my Track tab and track this normally. One more good thing to realize is that the spline that we create with the object brush and the spline that's generated by Matte Assist is not going to be exactly one-to-one. So if I zoom in here, you'll see that these are different things. So there's not going to be a one-to-one correlation. But for the general type of tasks we're going to be doing in Sapphire, that shouldn't be a problem. The Matte Assist splines that we create are splines, so that they render fast, but they're not directly editable. So if we do find errors in them here, we can do one of a couple of things. We can either try to supplement the mat with additional reference frames. So if I come up into the object brush, go to the plus, and give this one another reference frame to work with. And I'll finish this here. And we can add multiple reference frames just as long as we remember to be working with the object brush with the plus in it and hit finish each time. Then when we re-render these frames, that should help to clean a lot of this up. but if they're still not as good as you need them to be, we can always supplement them with additional Mocha splines. And if you still need more accuracy than this can give you, then you can always use the traditional roto tools with inside of Mocha for subpixel perfect precision. If we see a dotted DL align with our mass assist, that means something has changed since the last time we rendered it. Now this will still work, and it will still be as accurate as it was when we first created it. But just know that the next time we come in and re-render this mask, something may change here. So if you've made a change and the line has turned dotted, it's worth rendering out just so you're 100% sure that what you're going to be getting is in fact what you expect. If Matte Assist isn't letting you render, just make sure that the Generate Object Matte button is turned on and applied, and then we can render all the way through. Likewise, if your spline isn't tracking through as you expect it to, ensure that the Generate Object Matte is turned off. And this will now work as expected. A layer can either use the tracking or the masking. It cannot use both. We can see the little silicon chip here is going to tell us whether we're generating the object matte automatically, or if it's off, we're going to be using the regular tracking. And one last thing. If we're working on longer clips with the AI-powered mats, you might want to actually add in extra reference frames along the way, even if you don't think you're going to need them, to get a good result. And I'll track through from the first frame. So both of these things can help to speed up processing, even though they're not necessarily required. And those are my top tips for working with Mocha, the Object Brush, and Matte Assist inside of Sapphire. If you've got any tips you want to share yourself, drop them in the comments below. If you want to see anything else related to Sapphire and you've got big questions there, again, we're always listening. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris FX. I'll see you again soon.